With Trump silent, Democrats demand aid for Iran quake victims. Tehran, Tasnim. As U.S. President Donald Trump remains entirely silent over a recent deadly earthquake in western Iran, Senator Bernie Sanders and four Democratic senators sent a letter to Rex Tillerson demanding that the White House waive certain sanctions on Iran and allow aid to reach those in need. After earthquakes in 2003 and 2012, the United States demonstrated its compassion and goodwill by offering assistance to the Iranian people and allowing private relief donations, the senators wrote, according to Common Dreams. This time should be no different. While the rescue and relief teams are still working in the quake hit areas after three cold nights, the latest figures show that over 450 people have died and 9,388 others wounded in the quake as of Saturday morning. The Sunday night's earthquake, measuring 7.3 on the Richter scale, whose epicenter was near Iraq's Sulaymaniyah, was the deadliest of the year, eclipsing the one that hit Mexico City in September, and was felt as far away as Turkey and Pakistan. Under the current sanctions regime, Iranian Americans living in the U.S. are prohibited from delivering funds to their friends and family members. Media reports say several attempts by Iranian Americans to set up fundraisers for Iran in the days following the earthquake have been stymied by U.S. Treasury Department rules. The way it is now, it is extremely difficult, Tara Kongarlu, a New York-based Iranian American journalist, said of the economic restrictions. These are the moments that you realize how political tug of war are hurting ordinary Iranians. As for official U.S. government assistance, the Trump White House has been relatively quiet. The Treasury Department called the quake tragic in a statement, but did not say whether the administration plans to mount any kind of response. Trump, himself, has not said a word about the quake, which Sanders and his Democratic colleagues noted was the world's deadliest of the year. In addition to killing hundreds and injuring over 9,000, a report from European Civil Protection and Humanitarian Aid Operations found that the tremor damaged 12,000 buildings in Iran and Iraq. Shortly after the earthquake struck, Sanders highlighted the growing tensions between the U.S. and Iran, particularly following Trump's decision to decertify the Iran deal, and argued that providing relief to the Iranian people following such a devastating event would be an important act of friendship. "We write today concerning the recent earthquake that struck Iran on November 12th. The latest reports indicate over 500 dead and thousands wounded, making this earthquake the world's deadliest of the year. We urge you temporarily waive any existing restrictions that would impede relief donations in order to speed the delivery of aid." While the earthquake affected both Iran and Iraq, most of the casualties are on the Iranian side of the border. After earthquakes in 2003 and 2012, the United States demonstrated its compassion and goodwill by offering assistance to the Iranian people and allowing private relief donations. The administrations of George W. Bush and Barack Obama both temporarily waived sanctions, and the Department of the Treasury's Office of Foreign Affairs